I was born and raised in a corner of the Venetian inland about half an hour from Venice. That's where my family has lived for as long as I can remember. The landscape has always been, well, rural, deeply rural, but also charming in its own and showy way. Families like mine lived on farms. Life was humble and frugal, but the food was good. Food was everything. I grew up in close proximity to my grandparents, in a village surrounded by fields and open spaces. Most families kept a kitchen garden, and we did too. So our kitchen was often invaded by fresh, seasonal produce. I was very spoiled. I learned to cook from mom and from grandma, mostly by just observing them at work and sometimes helping. Their cooking was simple, straightforward. They both taught me early on that there's no need to mess around with delicious ingredients when they're so fresh. It's a lesson I carry with me and that I think is reflected in the way I cook today. The idea for my first cookbook, Veneto, spurred from my wish to tell my story and the story of my family and of our land, and to share the recipes that are bound to us all. It's a personal book, full of anecdotes and snippets of family life. Food is very much part of the narrative. The book has 100 recipes, and they're divided between traditional and modern. Some are more iconic, some are more niche, but hopefully they'll all be surprising. I like to think that they're approachable, simple, seasonal, and, well, very Venetian. Many of the recipes have been included because of the story they carry, but of course, also because I think that they're very good and representative of the region and its food, and because I'm confident that they'll make themselves at home in any kitchen, in any family, no matter where.